Hi. In this video, I'm going to do some example problems and vectors for you to be able to do the six problems you need to do on the vector lab. First thing we're going to do is add two vectors. I have vector A and vector B. Vector A is 40 newtons at 30 degrees north of east. Vector B is 20 newtons at 50 degrees north of west. So, the equipment you need for this lab is a ruler, one you can use shorter than a meter stick, and a protractor. The other two pieces of equipment you need are a pen and a piece of graph paper. Please use graph paper. That way you can make sure your lines are as straight as possible. So, first thing we're going to do is draw a vector A. From the starting point, from the origin of my graph, I'm going to make a little origin. I'm going to make a mark of 50 degrees. Put the center point of my origin, 30 degrees, 30 degrees for vector A. And there's my mark. Next thing I'm going to do is draw the vector out for my scale. But what's my scale? The scale I'm going to use is 1 centimeter for each newton. 40 newtons, 40 centimeters. So from the origin through the 30 degree mark, I'm going to draw 40 centimeters. I'm going to put an arrow on the end, label it vector A, and draw my angle, 30 degrees. These are the things I look for when I'm grading your paper. Have you drawn the vector with the arrow, labeled the angle, especially on the answer, on the resultant vector. So next is vector B. And just like on a treasure map, you do step one, vector A, then you do step two, vector B. But you're starting, again, with an origin, right at the end of vector A. And I'm going to draw 50 degrees. This time, though, I start on the left side of my protractor because it's 50 degrees north of west. There's my 50 degree mark. I'm going to go ahead and draw 20 centimeters. And because I have 20 newtons, I'm going to draw 20 centimeters. So 20 centimeters lined up through the 50 degree mark. Vector B. So, the resultant vector is the one that starts back at the origin and goes all the way to the end of vector B, of the second vector. Start at my original origin. Go all the way to the tip here. I use R for the resultant. You can use C, just use a different letter. This is my resultant vector, so I have to do two things now. I have to get the magnitude and the direction. So the magnitude, easy enough, I just measure its length. It is approximately 43 centimeters long. So that would be 43 newtons. Don't forget, you've got to go back to the original units. Now I've got to measure the angle. I'm going to choose the angle that is north of east. I found that to be 59 degrees. I label it here. If I want to write the answer out, I give the magnitude, 43 newtons, at 59 degrees north of east. Now, one thing that students sometimes make a mistake in is they put northeast. Northeast is a very specific direction. It is halfway between north and east, which is 45 degrees. It needs to be 59.9 degrees north of east. And that's how you add our vector A and vector B.